When using Rigify, do you always get your hand pedal rotation slightly off? Or perhaps even worse, are your fingers out curling to the wrong places? And no matter how much you try to adjust it, it always seems to be just a little bit off. If so, here's how to understand and fix your problems. After you created your Rigify skeleton, it is quite common that your hand pedal might be slightly off. Especially if your models don't use the standard T-pose and you have to move the arm bones around. This will happen because Rigify will try to auto-detect the arm's rotation based on the bone's position. You can certainly try to fix this by repositioning the bones around over and over again. And in this particular case, I can get an okay result by moving the hand bone location just a few times. Rigify will try to guess the rotation based on the three arm bones' position related to each other. And the bone roll in this case does not affect this automatic detection. So this can be quite finicky, and the results are not always perfect. A better way to do this is for us to tell Rigify the rotation ourselves. First, go to the data panel and enable the Show Axis option, so we can see how each bone is rotated. I will also change the display, so it's easier to see them. Now, select the upper arm bone and click on the Bone tab. There's nothing much here yet, and that's because we need to be in the pose mode. Now we can see the Rigify Type section. This is what Rigify uses to set up all those gizmos and interactions when we press the Generate Rigify Rig button. This is a limbs.arm type that creates the whole arm and is composed of three bones. And in here, we have the rotation axis that is set to automatic. The upper arm is what controls the whole arm, so if you select the other bones, you won't see this option. You need to select the upper arm. Now, let's change the rotation axis to X manual. This means the local X axis is what will control the rotation of the limb. So we want to have the Z axis pointing towards the direction of the rotation. In this case, the elbow will rotate this way, which is already what we want. If we create the rig now, things have changed. Our hand pedal is very wrong. So let's go back to the meta rig and fix that. Without the repositioning while setting the rig, this hand seems to have rotated drastically. So I will select the hand bone and press Ctrl R to roll the bone to the correct position. We want to have our Z-axis pointing towards our thumb here, so go and rotate around the hand and make sure it is right. Now let's create the rig again. And there we go, our hand pedal is looking very nice. And if we go into pose mode, we can see that the elbow is rotating correctly too. The other hand is still wrong. We need to apply the changes to the other side too. So go back to the meta rig edit mode, select all the arm bones, and use the armatures menu. Symmetrize command to replicate the changes to the other side. Then just regenerate the rig, and that is done. Now, let's take a look at those fingers. But first, let's quickly make our mesh move. Select the meshes and the rig last. Press Ctrl P and select with automatic weights. Our hands are moving fine, and we can move them around just so. Our thumb seems okay too, but when we try to curve the fingers, a nightmare happens. Some fingers have a really bad rotation, and we need to fix that. So let's go back and see why. The reason is the same. Rigify will try to guess the fingers' position based on their locations. So if you want to have your fingers curled properly, we need to position them in a way that will make each bone slightly lower than the other, following the rotation we want. And this is actually not that hard for fingers, as this is quite intuitive, and just placing them on the center of each finger will most likely give you correct results. But if you are having problems or want more precise control, we can do the same as we did with the arm. Select the root of the finger, go to pose mode, into the bone tab, and change the bend rotation axis. There are more options here, but you can still choose the X manual rotation. And now each finger will curl using the positive local X axis. You can preview the changes inside the pose mode too. Select all the finger bones, make sure the pivot is set to individual origins, and press RXX to rotate around each local X, and that curls all the fingers together. So knowing that, you can now use Ctrl R to roll the bones and test the changes. Make sure you enable manual rotation to each finger root bone. And after it is done, check all the bones and choose Armature Symmetrize to copy the changes to the other side. And that's it! Now hopefully you should be able to understand and solve all your hand and arm rotation problems with more precise control. I hope this video helps, and until next time.